Hey guys, so have you ever wondered what happens if somebody gets married, but they've only been married for a short duration, sometimes even less than a month, and then they have to file for the green card? What happens? How do you file such a case? Well, watch this video and I'll tell you more. My name is Jacob Sapochnik and I'm an immigration attorney based in San Diego, California. In this video, we're going to talk about short duration marriages and green cards. What happens when the marriage is so short and you want to file for the green card so fast? How to do this? Before that, if you're here for the first time, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We post videos every week. I want to make sure you won't miss any videos, so click that bell to be notified. We're also on Instagram. We have two accounts. You can follow our Instagram account. You can also send us a DM right there. And guess what? We are also on TikTok. So we'll put a link on our TikTok and maybe even here. TikTok is a new platform where we try different little short videos. So if you are on TikTok, find me over there and follow the conversation there as well. So let's talk about short duration marriages and green cards. So recently I had a lot of, quite a few clients who came to our office and they, you know, just met. So I'll give you an example of a recent case where the couple met in October. It was an amazing meeting. They met on a trip and then decided that they wanted to be together. So the husband, who was a US citizen, moved to San Diego where the foreign national lived. And so they met in October. They moved in together in late November. And then they decided to get married on just before Christmas. So it's a very short meeting, move in, and decided to get married. It's all passion and love and everything there. But what they realized is that when they came to see me, as they're telling me the story, they realized that it may be a problem if USCIS, the government, is going to look at it, because it doesn't look really normal as to what they see for somebody to meet in October and then move in November and then get married in December. It's really fast. And so what I told them is that, first of all, I was convinced that it was a real marriage. They met both their parents. They had a beautiful wedding with 250 people. The story is just an amazing story. But I know that they will face challenges, because when they're gonna end up in an interview, they're gonna ask them those questions. Why so fast? Why did you do that? The other issue is that the foreign national arrived to the U.S. Literally a couple of months a month before meeting the U.S. citizen. So she was literally here for 90 days, about 90 days, when they actually moved in together. So even her entry was somehow recent. So we have to kind of overcome some of these things. So first of all, when we're dealing with a marriage of short duration, you really have to look at what are the strengths versus the weaknesses that we have to deal with. So for example, in their case, the marriage itself took place after the 90 days. So it clearly, they didn't know each other when she entered. So there was no intent to marry that US citizen. So that's one thing that we can already clearly establish. The second thing is that while they were not living together for a long time, they had a very, very somehow big wedding. They had a lot of people that came to their wedding. They had 250 people that showed up. And so, and that's something, that's a kind of wedding that I sometimes don't see with couples that are dating for a few years, just because it's not so common in the US to have large weddings. But in their case, they had a wedding with, you know, a couple of hundred people. And so we use that as a very strong leverage to show to the USCIS that, listen, yes, they had this, you know, interesting, maybe strange story in your eyes, but they have this huge wedding, both families were there, everybody were there. They were also able to commingle their assets fairly quickly. So as soon as they moved in together, they already had a joint bank account, they're paying the rent from that same account, they had life insurance and health insurance that they established, because the US citizen had a pretty good job, so you immediately added her to his benefits. And they were able to do one big purchase. They were able, $5,000-$6,000 worth of goods to bring into the bedroom. So the point is that, yes, they didn't have too many pictures together. Yes, they didn't have too many trips. Yes, they didn't have too many bills. But what they did have was quite substantial. And so when we ended up at the interview, and I prepared them, and I said, and anybody who's watching right now, and you're in a short duration marriage, we're actually going to be preparing a free course to show you exactly how that filing should take place, not only in the preparation process that we're talking about right now, but also what kind of documents and how to prepare the petition so you have a bigger chance to get approved. So in this case, what happened in the interview is that the officer was questioning the fact, why did you move in so fast? Why did you get married so fast? Was it because her visa was going to expire? Was it because you wanted to help her stay in the country? And of course, I prepare them, they're going to ask them the questions, and they have clear answers. No, it was because we genuinely wanted to be together. It was because we were in love, and we didn't see any reason to wait. We just wanted to be together. As soon as we met, they drove to meet the parents. And so the point is this: yes, there was an investigation in the interview where they were questioning them. They didn't separate them, but they were asking questions about brothers, sisters, some personal questions, as much as they can know in those 3 months of being together. At the end of the day, the case was approved. But what I think the biggest factors in that case was that they had some evidence that most other people wouldn't have. So in this case, it was the big wedding. But even if you don't have a big wedding, you may have something else. Like maybe you do one big purchase together if you are, in fact, trying to show that it's a committed relationship. But the key is to show that you have something that maybe others won't have, even though that marriage is of short duration. At the end of the day, all that the USCIS cares about is that it's a bona fide marriage. There's no definition of what bona fide marriage is, but they do have certain things that they have to follow, and they also use a reasonable person's test to see if it actually makes sense, if that case makes sense. Now remember, even if you get approved at that first interview, after that fast wedding, the green card is only issued for 2 years because it's a short duration marriage. It's less than 2 years. And in 2 years, they have to prove again that it's a bona fide marriage, that it was a bona fide marriage, for them to be able to get a 10-year green card by removing the conditions. So if in fact they're not going to be able to establish that in the next 2 years, and this particular couple obviously will, but the idea is that as long as you can convince the government that it is a bona fide marriage in the beginning, then you would have 2 more years to build that case before you actually get your permanent green card. So these are just some tips for short duration marriage. Try to be really concise, try to have effective evidence that will make sense, and also be honest and truthful with the officers. If they ask you about things, you just say, listen, this is all we have right now. It was a short duration marriage. We just met, but we love each other, and here's what we have. And at the end of the day, if the story lines up, you will be able to get that conditional green card. So if you have any questions about this short duration marriage, post those questions below in the comments. Let me know what you think. And make sure that if you know somebody who may need that information, take that link and share that or tweet that and spread the word. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next video.